हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मीडियन। सो मीडियन मींस मिड वैल्यू ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और मिड वैल्यू ऑफ द गिवन डेटा। सो हियर आई एम राइटिंग डेफिनेशन अबाउट मीडियन, सो दैट इज इन शॉर्ट मिड वैल्यू ऑफ डेटा और डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। That is median divides distribution or data in two equal parts. So in data, if mid value divide means mid values divide data in two equal parts, so mid value is called as a median of that distribution. So if individual observations are there, in 9th standard we have learned that if individual observations are there, how we are going to find median. So here median of odd observations, odd number of observations, so if odd number of observations are there, how we are going to find median of this observation. So suppose observations are odd, so here I am considering x1, x2, x3 up to xn. These are observations, n observations, means if n is odd, so if n is odd, then formula to find median, that is median is equal to n plus 1 upon 2 observation. So whatever observation is there, n plus 1 upon 2 observation, that is a median. Before that, we have to arrange this data in ascending or descending order. So here I am taking one example. So if data is like this way, 1, 3, 6, 2 and 4 it is. So there are 5 observations are there. So first we have to arrange, and if we have to find the median of this observation, so first we have to arrange these observations in ascending order, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. And after that we have to find median of this data. So median is equal to, now here n is equal to 5. Formula is 5 plus 1 divided by 2 observation, that is 5 plus 1 6, 6 by 2, so third observation is equal to median. So third observation is here 3, so 3 is median of this data. Similarly, if even observations are there, so if even observations are there, formula is different. I am writing in that side, if n is even, so if n is even, formula of finding median, that is median is equal to n by 2 observation plus n by 2 plus 1 observation divided by 2. So if n is even, then formula is this to find median. So if I am taking example of even observation, suppose observations are 1, 4, 6, 8 and again here if I am taking 5 and 3. So here 6 observations are there, and if we have to find the median of these 6 observations, so first, again same procedure, first we have to arrange these observations in ascending order. So ascending order is 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, and then median is equal to, now here n is equal to 6, so we have to use this formula. So 6 by 2 observation plus 6 by 2 plus 1 observation divided by 2. 6 by 2 that is third observation plus 6 by 2 that is 3 plus 1 that is fourth observation divided by 2. So third observation is here 4 plus fourth observation is 5 divided by 2. 4 plus 5, 9 by 2 is equal to 4.5. So median of this data is 4.5. Okay, now we will take next data, that is if data is given, discrete median, discrete frequency distribution is given, then how we are going to find median of discrete frequency distribution. So here I am taking example, here already XIs are arranged in ascending order. If XIs are not arranged in ascending order, first arrange it in ascending order and corresponding frequency also. So here already XIs are arranged in ascending order and frequencies are given. Corresponding frequencies means suppose here 1 occur 8 times, 2 occur 10 times, 3 occur 11 times. Okay. Then how we are going to find median of this data, we will see here. So here first we have to find cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency means we have to add these frequencies, means first this frequency we have to write here as it is. Second, we have to add 8 plus this thing and we have to write this number here, that is 8 plus 8, that is 18. Now this 18 we have to add in 11, so 18 plus 11, that is 29. Then 29 plus 16, 29 plus 16, that is 45. After that 45 we have to add here in 20, 45 plus 20, 65. Then 65 plus 25, that is 90. 90 plus 15, that is 105 plus 9, that is 114, and 114 plus 6, that is 120. So this is called cumulative frequency. So this is less than cumulative frequency. If we start from top and if we add corresponding frequencies, then this is called less than cumulative frequency. So this is basically, it is called as a cumulative frequency. When we arrange these numbers, means here meaning of this cumulative frequency, we have to arrange these numbers in ascending order, and instead of writing horizontally, we have to write this is vertically, because here 1 of the 8 times means we have to write 1, that is 8 times, after that 2, 10 times, so 2, 10 times, similarly 3, 11 times, and then we have to find the midpoint or mid value of this observation, that is a median. So instead of this, we have to write cumulative frequency in form of cumulative frequency, and we have to write in vertical order. Okay, so we have to find median of this observation. So we have to find first n by 2. N means capital N, that is a summation fi, or here writing n is equal to summation fi. So summation fi, so summation fi, if we find this summation fi, that is a 120, because here we get answer is 120. So this 120 and summation fi is every time it is equal. Okay, so we can check by using this also. So n is equal to summation fi, that is equal to 120. Now we have to find n by 2. So 120 by 2, that is a 60. So here n by 2 is 60. Now after that we have to find a number which is a greater than, just greater than 60 in cumulative frequency column. So which number is greater than 60, that is a 61. And corresponding observation, so corresponding observation of this 65 in XI column, that is a 5. So median of this data is 5. Again, I am repeating this procedure. First, we have to find cumulative frequency, means we have to add these frequencies first frequency we have to keep as it is. So here I am keeping 8 as it is. Then 8 plus 10, 18. 18 plus 11, 29. 29 plus 16, 45. And last we got this is 120. So summation FI, that is a, so if we find this summation FI, that is a 120. After that we have to find N by 2. So N is equal to summation FI, that is 120. N by 2 we will get 60. So median, we have to find number which is greater than 60 in cumulative frequency column. So here 65 is just greater than 60, and after that we have to see corresponding observation of 65, that is a 5. So median of this data is 5. Okay, now if median of if class intervals are given, then how we are going to find median? We will see by using example directly. So median of a group or continuous frequency distribution. So if class intervals are not given in continuous, first we have to convert in continuous class interval. In mean, when we are finding mean, there is no need to convert class interval in continuous, but for median and mode, we have to convert class interval. If it is not in not continuous, then we have to first convert in continuous class interval. We know that how to convert class continuous are not there, then we know that how to convert in continuous class intervals. So first we will see what is the formula to find median of continuous frequency distribution. So median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF upon F into H. So here L is equal to lower limit of median class. L is equal to lower limit of median class. N is equal to, that is the summation FI. We know this. N is equal to summation FI. CF is equal to, so CF means cumulative frequency of a preceding class of a median class. So if we are finding median class is 25 to 30, then cumulative frequency we have to take for this class. So cumulative frequency of preceding to median class, then this F, that is a frequency of median class, not cumulative frequency, this FI. So frequency of median class, and H, that is a class size or class width. Here class size is 5, 10 minus 5, 5, or we can find like this way, 15 minus 10, that is a 5. So class size of this class intervals here 5, and if class size is different, no need to convert frequencies. In 900 we are converting for histogram, we have to convert these frequencies. If class size is different, here no need to convert class size or frequencies. Only we have to find median class, and whatever class size of that median class we have to take as a H. So here first you have to find your cumulative frequency. Class intervals are given, frequencies are given. We have to find first cumulative frequency. So 5 we have to write as it is. Then 5 plus 6, this is 11. 11 plus 15, 26. 26 plus 10, 36. 36 plus 5, 41. 41 plus 4, 45. 45 plus 2, 47. And 47 plus 2, 49. So here summation FI, here I am writing summation FI, that is a 49. N is equal to 49. You can check this also. This sum is also 49. That is N is equal to 49. Now we have to find first N by 2. So here this is, I am giving you equation 1 of formula number 1. So first I am finding N by 2. So N by N is 49. So 49 by 2, that is a 24.5. Now we have to find the number which is just greater than 24.5 in cumulative frequency column. So which number is here? 26. This 26 is greater than 24.5. So corresponding class, that is a 15 to 20, that is a median class. So this is median class. Then we have to write all this information. So here L is equal to, L means lower limit of this median class. So lower limit of this median class is 15. So L is equal to 15. Then N by 2 is 24.5, which is already written here. Then CF. Now here median class is 15 to 20. So preceding class is 10 to 15. So we have to take cumulative frequency of this class, that is a 11. So this is a CF. CF. 15 to 20 is a median class, and preceding median class, that is 10 to 15, we have to take cumulative frequency of this class. So this is a CF. 11 is equal to CF. So CF is 11. Then F. F, that is the frequency of median class. Frequency of median class is 15. So this is a F. So F is equal to 15. And H, class size of median class, that is a 15. 15 to 20 is class. So class size of this is 5. So H is equal to 5. Now we have to put all these values in this formula. So median is equal to L plus, so 15 plus N by 2 minus CF. So N by 2 is 24.5 minus CF is 11 divided by F, that is a 15, and into H is 5. Now we have 15 plus 24.5 minus 11, that is 13.5 divided by 15 into 5. So 5 under 5, 5, these are 15. So 15 plus 13.5 divided by 3. So 15 plus, this is 4.5. So 15 plus 4.5, that is 19.5. So median of given data or given frequency, continuous frequency distribution is 19.5. Okay, now we will take one more example. Calculate the median of following data. So class intervals are given. These class intervals are not in same size, so no need to convert frequencies according to the class size. Okay, only we have to find a median class and class size of that median class. So first we have to find cumulative frequency. So first we have to keep 5 this as it is, then 5 plus 15, that is a 20, 20 plus 30, this is a 50, then 58, and then 58 plus 2, this is a 60, that is a summation Fi, N is equal to 60. Now we have to find N by 2. So N by 2 is equal to 60 by 2, that is equal to 30. Now we have to find a number which is greater than 30. So here greater than 30 number is 50. So corresponding class, that is a 30 to 60. So this is a median class. So 30 to 60, that is a median class. Now we have to find all these values. So lower limit, L means lower limit of median class. So L is equal to 30. So L is equal to 30. Then N by 2 we have this 30. CF. CF means cumulative frequency of preceding class, of median class. So median class is 30 to 60. Preceding class is 10 to 30. So here cumulative frequency of this class is 20. So this is cumulative frequency. So 20. Then F. F is equal to frequency of median class. So frequency of median class, that is a 30. So this is F. So F is 30. And H, that is a class size of median class. So median class is 30 to 60. So class size of this class is 30. 60 minus 30, that is a 30. So h is equal to 30. Now we have to put all these values in this formula. So median is equal to L plus, so L is 30, plus N by 2, N by 2 is 30, minus CF, that is 20, divided by F, 30, and into H, H is 30 again. So 30 plus, this 30 will get cancelled, 30 minus 20, 10, 30 plus 10 is 40. So median of this frequency distribution is 40. Okay, here one more example we will take. Here class intervals are given which are not continuous. It is in inclusive form. So first we have to convert in exclusive form, that is a continuous class interval. So we know that how to convert inclusive class intervals in exclusive class intervals. So here first we have to find difference between this lower limit of class minus upper limit of preceding class. So here 70 minus 69, that is a 1, and 1 divided by 2, that is 0.5. so h, this h is different. Here I am writing this h is equal to, suppose capital H I am taking. So 70 minus 69, and that is a 1, and h by 2 we have to find. So h by 2 is 1 by 2, that is 0.5. In 9th standard we learned that how to convert inclusive class interval into exclusive class interval. So here 0.5 we have to subtract from all lower limits, and 0.5 we have to add to all upper limits. So here 60 minus 0.5, that is a 59.5. to here 69 we have to add 0.5, that is a 69.5. then next 70 minus 0.5, that is 69.5, and 69.5 to 79.5. similarly, this is 79.5 to 89.5 to 99.5, and this 99.5 to 109.5. last one is 109.5 to 119.5. okay, so we convert this inclusive class intervals into exclusive class intervals. Now again same procedure we have to find. First we have to find cumulative frequencies. So that is, first we have to keep as it is 5, then 5 plus 15, this is 20, 20 plus 20, 40, 40 plus 30, 70, 70 plus 20, this is 90, and 90 plus 8, this is 98. So summation FI, that is a 98. Now we have to find N by 2. So 98 by 2, that is a 49. Now we have to find a number which is a greater than 49 in cumulative frequency column. So here 70 is a number which is a greater than 49. Now corresponding class with this 70, that is a 89.5 to 99.5. don't take this class interval, we have to take a continuous class interval. So here median class is 89.5 to 99.5. so this is median class. Sometimes in exam only they can ask for 2 marks, find median class. So you have to follow this procedure and then find median class. Now L, that is the lower limit of this median class, that is 89.5. next N by 2, we already have this 49. CF, again CF, median class is this 89.5 to 99.5. preceding class is this 79.5 to 89.5. so cumulative frequency of this is 40. So CF is 40. So this is 40 frequency. frequency of median class, this is 30, so this is f, so f is equal to 30, and h, class size of this class interval, so 89.5 to 99.5, class size is 10, so h is equal to 10. Now we have to put all these values. So median is equal to L plus L is 89.5 plus N by 2, that is 49, minus CF 40 upon F. F is 30 and into H. H is 10. So 89.5 plus 49 minus 40, that is 9, divided by 10 into 10, 10 into 3, that is 30. So 89.5 plus 3, that is 92.5.